Everybody all set? Electronics are wonderful, aren't they? Well, thank you for coming. I know it's been kind of short notice this morning, but we appreciate your being here. You know, the aging process is kind of interesting. I just talked to our whole staff and told them about it. You know, I heard about this guy not long ago who was kind of shriveled up and gray hair, looked like he was older than dirt. And a young reporter thought he'd go and talk to him and find out what the secret of his longevity was. And so the guy said, it's pretty simple. He said, I'm a very heavy drinker. He said, I smoke 3 packs a day. I never exercise. I hate exercise. And the only food I eat is deep fat fried. Want nothing to do with fruits and vegetables and stuff like that. And a young reporter was impressed. He says, my goodness. He said, well, how old are you actually? And the guy said, well, I just turned 35 last week. So I can relate to that somewhat. I've not really followed that guy's formula for aging, but it still happens. It's part of the deal, and you can't escape it. And I guess this was really driven home to me at Tim Miles' first press conference several months ago. A lot of you were there, and I think maybe the third or fourth question that Tim was asked was, well, what's it like to work for a 75-year-old AD? And Tim handled it pretty well, and but, you know, that's part of the deal. And so at some point, whether you're able to function or not, just the perception that you're getting old can get in the way. And I don't want to be one of those guys that everybody's walking around wringing their hands trying to figure out, well, what are we going to do with him? And that sometimes happens. So the chancellor and I have had some discussions. And so as of January 1, I will step aside as athletic director. And of course, Harvey needs some time to go through the process of finding a new one. So that's why we're here today rather than waiting until December 31st to tell you, because obviously it's got to be an open process. And the decision will be his, and I'll support him any way I can. I plan to probably be around for 6 months or so after January 1 to help in any way that I can in the transition. There's always a few things that maybe the new AD may not be aware of, and so try to help the transition. Also, I'll help in recruiting. I do a lot of that right now, meet with a lot of recruits. So if some of the coaches want me to do that, I'll be glad to do it. Want to make sure the building projects are completed, although they're pretty much on autopilot. I don't know there's a whole lot that I can add to the process. And there's a few things that over the next 3 months, you know, the thing that I'm concerned about is, you know, when you're a lame duck, things can really scatter. And so I've already talked to the staff about, you know, we need to still stick together, and there's a lot of things we need to do. So we'll work on those issues. Lastly, let me just say this, that you never know when you're on the inside exactly what the perception of a program is. But I feel that we're well positioned. We've worked hard on culture, and part of that has not just been internal. We've tried to make this a place where the former players feel good about coming back. We've tried to make it a place where the fans are somewhat unified and supportive. And I would like to thank the fans, because whatever is accomplished here could not happen if we didn't have a very loyal and very unified fan base, which is probably pretty hard to find one that would be equal to our fans around the country. And so it enables a program in a state of 1.8 million people to be very competitive with more densely populated areas. We've worked hard with our student athletes. I think they represent us well. Academics are good. Facilities, I think, can be as good as there are in the country. And I really like the people we have in place. Administratively, support staff, and then coaching staff. I feel very good about them. So hopefully 3 years, 4 years from now, a lot of great things will have happened and will continue to happen. Lastly, let me just say that I've enjoyed working with Harvey. He probably is as knowledgeable, if not more knowledgeable, than any other university president regarding athletics, NCAA rules, and so he's been very good to work with. He's been very supportive of athletics, and we certainly appreciate that. I'm honored that he would have asked me to do this job 5 years ago. At the time that he asked me, I wasn't sure if it was a good idea or not, but hopefully it's worked out well. And I guess the next move is his. And with that, I'll give the floor to Harvey, and thank you again for coming.
Thanks, Tom. It's been a real privilege to be able to work with Tom directly and closely over the last 5 years. I think he's done an extraordinary job for athletics and for the university. I'm not going to spend the time today to review all of his accomplishments. I think there will be plenty of opportunities to do that. But he certainly stabilized the department. He's hired several very promising coaches. He's brought our facilities to a new level, and I think importantly that the first facility he moved on was life skills and academic counseling. It tells a little bit about his views and about the culture of our athletic department. And it was obviously fun to work with him in moving Nebraska to the Big Ten. It wouldn't have happened without his support, that was a good time for both of us. I've had the opportunity to travel with him and to work with him, and there are people who you can admire from a distance, and then when you get up close, you see all the warts and all the other things. That's not true with my experience with Tom. It's been really fun to watch, to interview head coaches with him, and to see the kind of national respect and awe that they have of his reputation, his position in the coaching community. It's been great to see him, and in some ways sympathetic to him, to have to walk from one place in a foreign stadium to another, and a walk that would take 5 minutes usually takes him 20 because of all the people that want his autograph or to say hello. I think we probably don't recognize in Nebraska the extraordinary respect that he's held nationally, not just in intercollegiate athletics, but in other venues as well. So we should and we will celebrate his accomplishments. We'll appreciate his over 40 years of service to the university. And we should respect his explanation for the decision that he's made today. And he, of course, has my personal thanks that he'll stay through the transition. And I know that he'll be an important part of this athletic department for as long as he wants to be, because he is a real treasure. To anticipate some of the questions you might ask, Tom and I have had a number of conversations about his interest in continuing and his interest in retiring. And what I asked him was that he should give me a couple months' notice before he makes a public announcement. So he informed me in August that it was his intention to serve through this football season and to retire January 1. As you can imagine more than most, the search for a successor in this athletic department, given its visibility and importance to the state of Nebraska, is not one that can be done easily and cannot be done in the public eye. I think Nebraska is an important enough place in intercollegiate athletics that we should be able to attract the very best to this position. And I can tell you that individuals who currently hold high-profile positions in intercollegiate athletics will not participate in a public search. And so I do not intend to hold an open public search for this position. I think it would limit our opportunities and limit the kinds of people that we could attract and have conversations with. I will tell you, I have already begun the search. I have hired a nationally known search consultant, Jed Hughes, from Korn Ferry International. He heads their international sports division. He was the search consultant that hired most recently the athletic director at Michigan and the new commissioner of the Big 12. He is knowledgeable about intercollegiate athletics. He is well networked in intercollegiate athletics. More importantly, with my conversations with him, I think he understood that it's not just experience and credentials, it's a personality and a viewpoint that has to fit with Nebraska and what Nebraska's accomplished and what our ambitions and our culture is. And I think he has a very good understanding of that. He has and is continuing to conduct an exhaustive search of credentials of people around the country who we might be interested in and who might fit the Nebraska scene. He will look at the credentials of people within this department as well as external people. I will tell you that I have already interviewed candidates for the position. It may well be that I will interview more. I say that only so you can have the fun following my car and tail numbers, just to keep track of me. That way I'll know where I am. I have invited about 12 to 15 individuals to serve as my advisors in this search. They represent a broad segment of the constituents, from coaches to former student athletes to donors to members of the Lincoln and Nebraska communities. And I have engaged with them with respect to the credentials and the kinds of things that one would want in a successor. I can also assure you that Tom will play an important role in advising me about that selection as well. So that's where we are. I hope that we will have a successor reasonably soon, but I don't intend to say anything more about the search until we have an announcement. So with that, I guess Tom and I will open it up for questions, and you can ask us what you want.
For both of you, could you reflect back on 5 years ago, the circumstances that brought Tom to this position, and you know what you look back on it now compared to what you thought of it then?
Well, that's not exactly a time I care to spend a lot of time reflecting back on. It was unfortunate, but you know, I think we are all very fortunate that Tom agreed to step up, and there was considerable anxiety among the fans and supporter of Husker Athletics, and I think the last 5 years has demonstrated Tom's ability to bring that those constituents together.
Tom, could you also reflect on, you know, October 2000?
Well, yes, I was, first of all, very surprised. I think it was on a Sunday afternoon when Harvey gave me a call. I was teaching over in the College of Business. Life was good. I could have a long weekend when I wanted to, and enjoyed the students. And so I was very surprised to get that call. And we thought about it, talked to Nancy for a day or two, and decided that athletics was important to the state. Seemed to bind a lot of elements together, and I thought, well, if I could help, I should try. And so on an interim basis, came over here. Would maybe make one comment on the internal aspects of the athletic department. I may have told this before, but you know, when you get old, you repeat yourself a lot, so bear with me. But the first meeting, the first day that I was on the job was 8 o'clock in the morning, and walked into a meeting of the executive team, and we had two or three mental health counselors were talking to them about stress reduction. And I thought, well, this is odd. And so obviously there was, I wouldn't say things were awful, but things were a little fragmented, and some people had quit, and some people were thinking about quitting. And so it was a kind of a difficult time, but people pulled together very quickly. And so I think hopefully it's worked out well. And I feel, as I said earlier, I feel the culture of the department is solid right now. So that's about all I can remember about it. I'm probably healthier today than when I was a member of Congress. That takes a big toll on you. But no, I'm fine. I have no special issues. Everybody knows I had a double bypass in 1985. And so I've got a few wires in me and a few things internally that probably wish you didn't have. But no, I'm feeling good. So.
Tom, you mentioned at Coach Miles' press conference. Mm-hmm. Was that maybe your first time you felt some semblance of closure or peace of mind, knowing that facilities have been built, you have a new basketball coach?
No, not really. I thought maybe that this summer was the time to retire. But, you know, we had just hired Tim. Jamie Williams had recently been hired. Jamie Vaughn, compliance director, had just recently been hired. And I felt that it was important that I stay on for a few months, get their feet on the ground, and a few things I wanted to do. And I guess, you know, if you've been in athletics a long time, you always are tempted to take one more grab at the brass ring, you know, with football, volleyball, and So that's probably part of it, too, you know. But anyway, this seems to be the right time, and so we'll hopefully make it work.
Coach, can you speak more specifically to your future plans and how you hope your legacy will be remembered?
You know, that legacy question is a tricky one, and I'd rather you guys wrote it than me, because I don't really have any particular thoughts on that. But just as I told you, after January 1, I will be here for a while. Not sure where, but I'll be somewhere. I just talked to George Sullivan down the hall. He's got about a 4x4 cubicle. And so maybe George will share some space with me. But anyway, we'll find a place. And then, like I told you, I want to be available for the completion of the facilities. You know, we got a lot of things going on, and John Ingram and others are very, very capable of getting that done. But I will assist the new AD any way I can. But I also am smart enough to know not to meddle. And that guy may come in here, and on day two, he didn't want me around. If that's the case, then I won't be around. But I will be willing to help coaches or student athletes or anybody. And in about July, I plan to probably ramp up my activities with teammates. We'd like to go from 6,000 matches to 10,000 in about the next 3 years. And it's going to take a lot of effort. I think I can help in that regard. So that's about it.
Now, thinking back to 2007, did you have any sort of time frame in mind?
No, I didn't, because at that time, as I mentioned, I worked at the pleasure of the chancellor, and it was an interim appointment. And after I'd been here for a few months, I told Harvey that it would be helpful to me to not to take that interim off, because, you know, sometimes people are just saying, well, I'll go along with the guy, but he's not going to be here very long, and so whatever he thinks doesn't make any difference anyway. And so he was kind enough to say, yeah, we'll take that off. And so I didn't have any specific plan, but I suppose 5 years is probably about long enough. And I used to have I had a grandfather who was a preacher. And he felt he should move about every 5 years, because he felt he'd made about as much contribution as he could within 5 years. And, of course, I coached a lot longer than that. Many of you may have thought, well, maybe I should have moved on after 5 years. But anyway, it's been enjoyable for me, and so I've enjoyed it. Yep. Oh, not really. I think that culture is always the most important thing. You know, people look at facilities and they think you got to have this building, that building, and finances. But it's really the people that make it work. And we had some pretty good things happening here without extravagant facilities for a long time. And most of that had to do with culture. And I think that at this point, we've got our former players behind us and involved. I think the fans are pretty well engaged, and I think the people in the athletic department are working together. And so to me, that's probably the most significant thing. And but a lot of other good things. I think the Big Ten move will be good, and of course, appreciate Harvey's role in that. It's been interesting. So. See where it all goes.
What's Nancy think of this?
Well, she's probably more approving than disapproving, but it leaves me with a great deal of fear and trepidation, because she keeps reminding me that the garage has not been cleaned for about 3 years, and I can see a whole list of things popping up. But that's all of you who are married understand those things. So.
How do you feel about your accomplishments as the athletic director, as opposed to, you know, congressional or coaching accomplishments? How does that
work? Just like I said, I don't know. I feel good about where we are as a program. I hope it's a good situation for somebody to come into. I like the trajectory, and you know, nobody's really going to know how this has all worked out for probably another 3 years. But I really like what I've seen of Tim Miles. I think he's doing a great job. I think Bo's doing very well. Of course, Pepin is a known quantity. John Cook's a known quantity. You know, wrestling's going to be good. And baseball, softball, going to be good. So we think we're going to do very well. And so I feel good about the program. Oh, not really. I got another 3 months here, 8 months, whatever. So I'm not nostalgic particularly, but it's been fun. I was sitting there waiting for you guys to come, and I was watching the crew working over across the way, and that's kind of interesting to watch that and all the building that's happening. Okay, that's probably enough for me. Harvey, you want any
I don't want them, but questions? I'll take them if you got them. Well, I think that ought to be clear, and it almost becomes a cliche, but obviously I think anytime you hire someone, there are risks associated with that, and person comes into a new job, from their point of view, there are risks associated as well. So, you know, I suppose ideally someone with the kinds of experiences that you can make judgments about as to what their judgments are and what their skills are. But most importantly, I think they have to understand the rich tradition of this department and the culture of this department and what has made Nebraska athletics so important to the state of Nebraska, what Nebraskans are proud of about this department. Has to convince me that they understand that and fit that model and will continue that culture.
Culture is a bit of a vague word. Can you describe the culture within this department?
Well, I'm not referring to the internal culture. I'm talking about the role that athletics plays in the state of Nebraska. I think it is the pride that Nebraskans have for not only winning and losing, but for the holistic view that we take of student athletes, that life skills are important, that academic success is important, that these students are going to be out as adults and as part of their of the athletic department's role, just like in the university, our real role is to train them to be successful. So I think that's a commitment. I think engagement of the fans, you know, fans play an important role here. Former student athletes play an important role here, and I think you have to be open and embracing of all of the constituents of athletics.
Okay. Anything else? Okay, thanks.